Honorable Vincent, let's talk about the 22 billion shillings that was allocated to you. You are mandated to give accountability to the country how you use this money. How did you use the money?
Money. Don't emphasize this money. Other countries like Algeria, like Morocco, find out how much they used when they were invaded. We are talking about, I think they used over $300 million. $300 million in just one country. You are talking about 11 billion or 22 billion Ugandan shillings. This is not a lot of money, by the way.
One day you'll be put to account for every single coin that has been given to you.
Well, I have to gather all of the locusts that have been killed and bring them in sacks. Otherwise, what do you want me to do? Because the chemical has been sprayed. The receipts are there. Maybe the receipts. What do you want me to do? The food has been eaten. The milk, you want me to keep the packets of milk. But you know you have 3,000 people there consuming milk every day. 3,000. You know you have 3,000 people eating every day. You want me to keep the packets of posho to show that the posho was eaten? How are they surviving if they are not eating? The 22 billion, half of it, 11 billion, was taken to DLCO to pay our debt. We have been paying, but we have not been paying to the full. So every time we pay, they are left a balance. And the balance had accumulated.
How much did you spend on chemicals?
We paid Japan 2.6 billion or around 2.7 to Japan. That one has been paid, but the chemical has not been received. Twiger Chemical, which is the agency that is supposed is in Kenya, it has to get the chemical from Japan. Then it comes as powder. Then it is mixed to become soluble, become liquid. Then it can be used in the aircraft in Kenya. It is done in Kenya.
Okay. What happened to the rest?
Okay, then 3.6 billion was to hire the aircraft in Kenya, because we couldn't. We had planned to have three. Then, of course, then we had to maintain the army on the ground, to maintain the UWA, the protective wear, then the lorries, then the fuel, then the food, then the milk. People have to drink milk, those who are spraying. All of this is being used every day, even now, even as I talk now. When I'm in Karamoja and I say, well, we are fighting not to allow these swarms to reach the other side, it is as if we want those people to suffer and the others to be protected. No. That's what they think. People should understand this. You here, you are saying, where are they? We have not seen them. Maybe these people are lying. They are just eating our money. When our people are suffering on the ground, when our people are really suffering, you don't want to be part of it. You don't want to consume these chemicals in your... Now, you are putting on these masks. So, but again, we can't just look on.
You feel unfairly treated, that yes, some people think that you're saving
yes,
the money.
Yes, I really feel bad. And our people on the ground, the people I lead, the technical officers who are on the... By the way, we have a surveillance team headed by a whole professor. Was on the ground. They have never left the ground since the swarms came. But
you're looking for 16 billion shillings extra, more.
I don't know whether it will be enough. I'm not looking for only 16 billion. I've already asked other donors to help us. This is not enough. It is just because I know our... So that's what... Fortunately for us, the FAO team is there. The World Food Program people are there. The DLCO is there. That is why we are now lucky that FAO has now committed some money to buy some chemicals again from Japan to complement what we have been able to buy.
Thank you so much.
That's the
Thank
story.
Thank you for speaking to us.
Thank you.
Well, I've been speaking to Honorable Vincent Bamlanga Chisempija, the Minister for Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, trying to explain to us that the locust battle is not yet over. They are still monitoring the eggs perhaps that were laid in the previous evasion.
But and also fighting.
They're also managing the new swarm that is coming into the country.